I'm going to talk to you about coalition building in the River IJssel. In the Netherlands, the maintenance of rivers is the task of Rijkswaterstaat. This means, for example, maintaining the navigation channel and ensuring that vegetation does not block the view. Rijkswaterstaat enters into 5-year contracts to execute the work. However, Rijkswaterstaat is facing several challenges. They need to maintain large areas with lower budget and it needs to become more sustainable. So, in 2011, some people in Rijkswaterstaat took the initiative to start a new program called Self-Supporting River System, or SSRS. The idea was that the natural capital and dynamics of the river could be used much better by all sorts of societal actors. The river is not for Rijkswaterstaat alone. Instead, innovations in use and management could lead to a reduction in cost and generate benefits, so that the river could support itself. In 2015, a new maintenance contract had to be agreed for the IJssel River and the Twente canals in the east of the Netherlands. The SSRS initiators took the opportunity to include an appendix in the contract stating that an innovation team had to be established. This meant that the IJssel River became available as an experimental space. The Twente canals also became available as experimental space. So, innovation teams or coalitions had to be built and generate and facilitate innovations in river and canal maintenance. This is unusual. Normally, there's very little incentive for innovation. Here, the river contractor has to, because of the contract conditions. Moreover, the areas under maintenance contracts are usually close to other contractors and entrepreneurs. But with this appendix to the contract, the area became open for experimentation. Quite revolutionary, don't you agree? So, what is this innovation team? It's based on principles of cooperation in what we call the Golden Triangle. Representatives from governmental authorities, Rijkswaterstaat in this case, the market and private sector, the contractor in this case, and a knowledge institute or university work together. The actors jointly develop initiatives and cooperate to innovate. They work as a single project team and so dare to share risks, knowledge and initiatives rather than keeping it for themselves. And how does that work in practice? When a new team with new people is installed, they first need to get to know each other and agree on the rules of how they wish to work together. So, for example, they visit each other's organizations, the river area, and develop a common work plan. But most importantly, ideas were generated and collected in several collaborative sessions to stimulate innovation. Then the ideas were assessed. One way this was done was by identifying the maturity of the innovation, not only technologically, but also from a stakeholder perspective. Are stakeholders ready to adopt innovation? And if not, what still needs to be done? Knowing this, a plan was then made of how to take the idea further. This often involves knowledge development, connecting people together and improving the innovation by increasing its benefits and reducing the cost. Pilot projects are a powerful instrument to facilitate such a process. So the innovation team initiated and organized several pilot projects. Here you see some examples of the pilot projects. First, there is the idea of the flexible groins that promise easier maintenance, use less material, and above all, reduce erosion. Second, we introduced herded sheep to keep the vegetation sufficiently low instead of having to use mow using machines. Using sheep in this way is part of the cultural heritage of the Netherlands and could potentially boost the biodiversity. Here you see a bubble barrier designed to divert plastic onto the riverbank so that the plastic can be removed. Here it's being tested. With regular river maintenance, a lot of tree trunks are collected from forests along the river. Instead of having to dispose these, they can be used in the area itself. Here, three wooden screens have been constructed that reduce the impacts of waves on the banks and so prevent bank erosion. Another innovation is the semi-autonomous aquatic drone that can be used for monitoring the river. It has also been used for monitoring at the other pilot project sites. You can see that this is a diverse range of innovations. But how was this arranged? How have the coalitions been formed to make this possible? cooperation in the Golden Triangle formed the starting point. However, the innovation team is an open platform. On the one hand, other external actors can also bring their innovations to the table. On the other hand, particular innovations affect other actors as well, and they should or could be included in the process. This can include other governmental bodies, such as municipalities or ministries, diverse market parties, for example, the organizations that developed the aquatic drone or the bubble barrier, and diverse knowledge partners that can contribute specific knowledge or studies. But above all, societal actors also became part of the process. These can be nature organizations, cooperative of shepherds, or even local scouts. So the triangle is no longer just a triangle. Now, what conditions contribute to innovation in coalitions? First, different knowledge sources are accessed and diverse facilities are brought together. Second, equal or egalitarian relationships are required. So that means letting go of the traditional roles of client-contractor, for example, which increases creativity and support. Third, taking the full lifetime of infrastructure or innovations into account makes working on a long-lasting innovation process possible. Fourth, the presence of the experimental space. Fifth, the focus on shared interest so that there's something for all parties. Sixth, well-organized interactions between the coalition partners and the actors around them, including those from the same organization. This is particularly important for large governmental bodies where there are different departments, each having partially overlapping interests. Seventh, an innovation budget that helps to kickstart an innovation process. And in its turn, it can also help to find other additional resources. And eighth, the broader implementation needs to be prepared. What is the potential of the innovation and what changes, technical or organizational, are needed? Now, what did an innovation team achieve? Well, new coalitions emerged with the innovation team as the basis. This soon extended into broader coalition depending on the needs of the particular innovation. For the participants in the pilot projects, it also means that they are at the forefront of the innovation. And many ideas were collected, generated and advanced. Some went from small laboratory tests to full-scale pilot projects. Without the innovation team, this team structure, this would not have happened. Alone, the actors would not have invested time, effort and money. Furthermore, the team created added value for the innovations. For example, by connecting activities into the pilot projects, such as waste collection or creating work opportunities for people at a distance to the labor market. When an innovation creates more value, its chance of success increases. Of course, an innovation team needs to deal with many challenges. Apart from critical conditions in any coalition, like trust and finding a good working mode, it is necessary to find and keep the intrinsic motivation to participate. Participants need to be able and willing to look beyond the benefits of a single innovation. One innovation might be more interesting than another, but the cumulative value of long-term cooperation, finding new partnerships, and being at the forefront of innovation should provide ongoing motivation to participate. Second, innovation always comes with uncertainties. Clear insights in cost and benefits is not always available, which makes participants hesitant to invest. But without the investment, the knowledge gaps cannot be addressed, so there is the risk of a chicken and egg situation. The third risk is the absence of active leadership. This is necessary for innovation. But what does the future hold for the innovation team? First, some of the pilots I showed you will continue after the contract period. This is even the case when another contractor is active in the area. Second, the concept of an innovation team has been fully accepted by Rijkswaterstaat as a realistic option for new maintenance contracts. This has even been already applied in some new contracts. At least two will become active in the coming year. The potential of an innovation team also has been recognized by the European Agency on Public Procurement.